good is sitting alone in your room. Come hear the music play. Life is a cabaret, old chum. Come to the cabaret. Down the knitting, the book and the broom. It's time for a holiday. Life is a cabaret, old chum. So come to the cabaret. Come taste the wine. Come hear the band. Come blow your horn, start celebrating. White this way, your tail's waiting. No use admitting some prophet of doom to wipe every smile away. Life is a cabaret, old chum. So come to the cabaret. I used to have this girlfriend known as Elsie, with whom I shared four sordid rooms in Chelsea. She wasn't what you call a blushing flower. As a matter of fact, she rented by the hour. The day she died, the neighbors came to sneak her. Well, that's what comes from too much pills and liquor. But when I saw her laid out like a queen, was the happiest corpse I've ever seen. I think of Elsie to this very day. I remember how she turned to me and said, what good is sitting all alone in your room? Come hear the music play. Life is a cabaret, old chum. So come to the cabaret. And as for me, I made my mind up back in Chelsea. When I go, I'm going like Elsie. Start by admitting from cradle to tomb, it isn't that long a stay. Life is a cabaret, old chum. Only a cabaret, old chum. And I love a
Thank you very much. Welcome to With a Z, my tribute to Liza Minnelli and her lifelong collaboration with the composer and lyricist team, John Kander and Fred Ebb. That first number needs no introduction, probably one of her most famous ones. A little bit about the provenance of that, though. Liza was actually not the first person to record that. It actually was a one Miss Marilyn May back in 1966 when she was the commitment singer for RCA, and they would send her the things that they, the numbers they thought were going to be hits, and they would become turntable hits. Jill Hayworth actually got the role of Sally Bowles the next year in 1966 for the original. They thought Liza didn't have enough experience, even though she already had a Tony Award, but we'll get to that in a second. But she claimed the prize when she had the 1972 film directed by Bob Fosse, Cabaret, and of course walked away with the Oscars, so it was great. So the next one, she asked right off the heels of Cabaret 1972, she continued her collaboration with Bob Fosse in the television special Liza with a Z. Kander Ebb provided a lot of the music there. Halston did the costumes. Those of you who watched Halston on Netflix saw that they were very, very good friends. But this next song really is about the storytelling that Liza always does and the wonderful things that Kander Ebb wrote for her and really made her sound. So one second, I hope you enjoy. Gather around, I've got a story to tell about a Manhattan lady that I know very well. her name, she lived at 5 Riverside. Her name is Shirley DeVore, and she traveled round the world to meet the guy next door. Well, there was trouble inside apartment 29E. Her Shirley's mother and dad were as upset as can be. They said, "We hate to complain, dear, and we don't like to grouse, but you're nearly 32, you should get out of the house. You gotta ring them bells, you gotta ring them bells, you gotta make them sing and really ring them bells. It's such a happy thing to hear them ting-a-ling, you gotta ring them bells." Well, Shirley was 31, which she was loath to admit, and she had never been loved, which didn't thrill her a bit. And so she sat and she thought for hours on end, and said, "I'll go to Chase Manhattan, where I got me a friend." And so she borrowed a thou and called TWA, and told her mother and dad that she was up and away. "I'm gonna travel the continent a month, maybe two, and haul me home a huzz if it's the last thing I do." You gotta ring them bells, you gotta ring them bells, you gotta make them sing and really ring them bells. It's such a happy thing to hear them ting-a-ling, you gotta ring them bells. She tried a Londoner first, but they did not hit it off, as every time she approached, he had a bronchial cough. And then she went to Madrid and tried a handsome senor, but he liked to throw the bullet, he was no matador. She also fell down in Brussels, in Mallorca, in Rome, till someone said, "Try dropping, dear, before you go home, 'cause it's the kind of the town where you'll be likely to fall, and all the German cognoscenti find the Balkans a ball." You gotta ring them bells, you gotta ring them bells, you gotta make them sing and really ring them bells. It's such a happy thing to hear them ting-a-ling, you gotta ring them bells. She went to Dubrovnik, and the very next day she met a guy on the beach who took her reason away. Yes, it was love at first sight, and what a beautiful scene. She said, "My name is Cheryl DeVore." He said, "I'm Norm Saperstein." She said, "Are you from New York?" He said, "That can't be denied. I'm a swell junior pre at number 5 Riverside." Five? 5 Riverside Drive in New York? That's where you live? That's where I live. 5? Are you sure? As if that wasn't enough, poor Shirley thought she'd gone deaf when he told her his apartment there was 29F. Yes, she was E, he was F, and they had not even met until she traveled the world to Yugoslavia yet. He'd always been right next door, but she would never have known. If she hadn't tried Dubrovnik, she might still be alone. Well, there's a moral to learn from little Shirley DeVore, who had to travel the world to find her mother next door. You girls who live in apartments, don't just stare at the wall. Open up the door and hurry out in the hall. And ring them bells. Come on, ring them bells. Make them sing and really ring them bells. It's such a happy thing to hear them ting-a-ling. You gotta ring them, swing them, ring them. I want to introduce my friend and musical director and accompanist, Mr. Piano, Palm Springs, Joel Baker. So really thank you, Joel, for working on this little fun little ditty for me. So great. I also want to do a little promo here. We are broadcasting live from Frankie's Old World Deli and Bakery in Cathedral City, California. And the series Live at 5 is one that we've been doing for about a year and a half now. And Frankie and Luca here have a wonderful project called Project Bread for Musicians. Let me change out my prompts here real quick. We're casual here. So for folks who want to donate, if you bring in a gift card to Frankie's and drop it off here, these go to musicians and performers in the Coachella Valley who may be having just a little hard time during these trying times with COVID and everything. So please be generous, and you will get a lovely loaf of the Frankie's delicious home baked bread as well. So I wanted to just give a little plug there. So thank you, Frankie and Luca, for inviting me back. This next number comes from where Liza won her first Tony Award at the young age, tender age of 19. It comes from Flora, the Red Menace. It was Kander Ebb's very first collaboration on a Broadway musical. And at the time, she took away the Tony in 1965 at 19 years old. And she was, at the time, was the youngest to do that. So this is one of the signature songs from Flora, the Red Menace. Just the way you planned. It's funny, but the bells don't ring. It's a quiet thing. When you hold the world in your trembling hand, you think you'd hear a choir sing. It's a quiet thing. There are no exploding fireworks. Where's the roaring of the crowd? Maybe it's this strange new atmosphere way up here among the clouds. But I don't hear the drums, and I don't hear the the sound some say such moments bring. Happiness comes in on tiptoe. Well, what do you know? It's a quiet thing. It's a very quiet thing. But kind of escaped my orbit for the last several years and just heard a couple recordings and knew I had to do it. It's just one of the, I think, one of the most haunting and beautiful in their repertoire. And also, you know, Liza's known for the big drop the bomb right on them, you know, big numbers. But she also, when she does the ballad, it'll just tear your heart out. So, and it doesn't matter. So back to the Kit Kat Club. We are going back to Berlin. And this number was not in the original play, but this is actually written by Kander Ebb to put into the film. I think it's one of her signatures and one of the biggest numbers from the thing. It's really a real showstopper, so hope you enjoy. One more prop. Captain Pat, Liza. Okay. You have to understand the way I am, my hair. A tiger is a tiger, not a lamb, mein Herr. You'll never turn the vinegar to jam, mein Herr. So I do what I do. When I'm through, then I'm through. And I'm through. Toodaloo. Bye, bye, my. To care, I need the open air. You're better off without me, my hair. Don't dab your eye, my hair, or wonder why, my hair. You always knew that I was a rover. You mustn't knit your brow, you should have known by now. You've every cause to doubt me, my hair. The continent of Europe is so wide, my hair. And not just up and down, but side by side, mein Herr. I couldn't ever cross it if I tried, mein Herr. But I do what I can, inch by inch, step by step, mile by mile, man by man. Bye, bye, mein lieber Herr. Farewell, mein lieber Herr. It was a fine affair, but now it's over. And though I used to care, I need the open air. You're better off without me, my hair. Don't dab your eye, my hair, or wonder why, my hair. You always knew that I was a rover. You mustn't knit your brow, you should have known by now. You every cause to doubt me, my hair. My lieber Herr, auf Wiedersehen, mein Herr. Es war so gut, mein Herr, und vorbei. Du gehst nicht vor, mein Herr, ab lieber vor, mein Herr. Du so mich nicht mehr hält in mein Herr. Bye bye, mein lieber Herr, and bye bye. Du gehst nicht vor, mein Herr. To care, I need the open air. You're better off without me. You're better off without me. Mein Herr. There we go. Had to get the Liza move in there. Thank you, and thank you again, Joel. Fun one. Also, was my German coach too to help me. I took French in college. So we're gonna close out tonight. And thank you all, I should say. Thank you again to Frankie and to Luca and to Joel for helping me put this together, to be invited back to this wonderful room in Cathedral City at Frankie's Old World Italian Bakery. And thank all of you for tuning in. I really appreciate your support all these years. It just makes it so much fun. And so hopefully one day very soon you'll be, won't be just doing it in front of a camera, but we'll actually have a live audience. So I think we're getting close to that. But this last number comes from another film that Liza did. It's a pretty famous title, and the very famous title from it is one thing that people that think that Frank Sinatra actually originated, but actually it was Liza Minnelli with New York, New York. This isn't New York, New York, though. That's for a future show. This is one that they wrote for her, and it's a real signature of hers as well, so I hope you enjoy. Thank you. you're happy and sometimes you're sad, but the world goes round, and sometimes you lose every nickel you had, but the world goes round. Sometimes your dreams get broken to pieces, but that doesn't alter a thing. Take it from me, there's still gonna be a summer, a winter, a fall, and a spring. And sometimes a friend starts treating you bad, but the world goes round. And sometimes your heart breaks with a deafening sound. Somebody wins, and one day it's kicks, then it's kicks in the shins. But the planet spins, and the world goes round and round. But the world goes. The world goes round. One day your dreams get broken to pieces, but that doesn't matter at all. Take it from me, there's still gonna be a summer, a winter, a spring, and a fall. Treating you bad, but the world goes round, and sometimes your heart breaks with a deafening sound. Somebody loses, and somebody wins, and one day it's kicks, then it's kicks in the shins. But the planet spins, and the world goes round and around and round and around and round. The world goes round and round and round and round.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Joel. Good night.